Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of NSync by John F. Grabowski, narrated by Scott Shina.
Chapter 1. Disney in Concert. Being successful in show business, as in any field, is a combination of talent, hard work, and luck. The five young men, known as NSync, Chris Kirkpatrick, J.C. Chazet, Joey Fatone, Lance Bass, and Justin Timberlake, always had confidence in their talent. In the 3 years since Chris had formed the group in 1995, the boys had spent all their spare time fine-tuning their skills, practicing their singing and dancing for countless hours, day after day, week after week, month after month. Their diligence had already paid off in spectacular fashion. They signed a contract with BMG, one of the largest record companies in the world, and became a major hit in Germany. All across Europe, Asia, and Australia, thousands of fans flocked to see NSync. With their clean good looks and singing and dancing abilities, the Fabulous Five were one of the most engaging acts to hit the pop scene in years. Despite their immense European popularity, however, the boys had yet to make a splash in their homeland. Europe was at the forefront of the boy band phenomenon. The Backstreet Boys, to whom NSync was often compared, had only recently begun to make a name for itself in the United States. Backstreet Boys had also enjoyed early success in Germany. The time seemed right for NSync to break into the American market. The quintet's first single, I Want You Back, was released in February of 1998. The song received a great deal of play on radio stations across the country and won the group many fans, particularly among teenage girls. The fact that the five young men were all attractive as well as talented did not hurt their chances. However, as Lou Pearlman of Transcontinental Entertainment says, "You have to be able to sing first, or it doesn't matter how good-looking you are." The group's first album was released soon after the single, and it too had all the earmarks of a hit. The boys began playing shows around the United States and had just finished a concert at the Mall of America in Minneapolis, Minnesota. NSync was on a roll. The guys' music was catching on, and they were gathering new fans everywhere they performed. Now, an unexpected bit of luck came their way. The Backstreet Boys had been scheduled to film a Disney in Concert special for the Disney Channel. The concert, to be filmed over the Memorial Day weekend at the Disney MGM Studios, was to coincide with the opening of Animal Kingdom at Walt Disney World in Orlando, Florida. Plans do not always work out as expected, however. The Backstreet Boys canceled at the last moment, and NSync was invited to fill in. The boys jumped at the chance. It was a tremendous opportunity for the group, which had made Orlando its base of operations. On the Friday before the concert, the studio treated the boys and their families to a tour of the newest Disney attraction, followed by a press conference with members of the media at the Rainforest Cafe. Next, the five gave an interview for the Disney Channel. Afterwards, the boys had some free time to enjoy the park with their families before going home to rest up for the next day's performance. They took in the safari ride and the countdown to extinction in Disney's latest spectacle. Saturday began with a ceremony in which the boys set their handprints in cement in Disney's Walk of Fame. This ritual is a takeoff of the famous attraction outside Mann's Chinese Theater in Hollywood, California. But in Orlando, it features entertainers who have connections with Disney. Another press conference followed in the Beauty and the Beast amphitheater, this one for NSync's fans. Knowing how important their fans were to their success, the boys went out of their way to accommodate their admirers whenever possible. When one brave fan asked, "Today's my friend's birthday. Can you sing Happy Birthday to her?" the boys did not miss a beat. They immediately chimed in with an impromptu version of Happy Birthday to You, treating the young girl to a birthday memory she will undoubtedly cherish for years to come. The five boys spent the remainder of the time in last-minute preparations for the concert. As they performed, mixing in songs from their album with some new arrangements, they did not disappoint their audience. Energized by the large crowd, the five put on one of their best shows, harmonizing and dancing, and their fans loved every minute of it. By the time the evening was over, Chris, Joey, JC, Justin, and Lance knew the concert had been a success. They did not realize just how much of a success, however. "Even after we filmed it," recalled Chris, "we just thought it was a little concert. I was like, well, that was cool. Now we got to go work on our careers." On July 18th, the show was televised on the Disney Channel as part of the In Concert series. Other shows in the series, featuring performers such as Leanne Rimes and Brandy, had done very well. But NSync received the highest ratings of all. Because of popular demand, the show was repeated several times. The exposure brought the group countless numbers of new fans. Appearing on television could truly be said to have put them over the top. Those familiar with the boys' singing talents had their first exposure to the group's dancing prowess. Candid footage of the five and their families was included in the show, giving viewers the opportunity to get to know them a little more intimately. Because of the Disney show, NSync was no longer just a name on a CD label. The band was now a group of five likable young men ready to make their mark in their homeland, just as they already had in countries around the globe. They were talented, hip young singers and dancers who could thrill fans of all ages with their dancing abilities on stage as well as with their vocal talents. The boys had created a group with whom millions of fans the world over are in sync. Chapter 2. The Boys of NSync. Looking back on it now, it does not seem surprising that
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.